What's up, y'all? It's Christian Covington. This week's video is about holding identities, being black and queer. I asked about 25 people who identify as black and queer to do this video, hoping to get at least 10, which I did end up getting 10. But for all of the other videos, I didn't have to ask as many people. A lot of the people who I asked ended up saying no, because they're either uncomfortable in their black and queerness, or they just weren't fully comfortable talking about those intersecting identities on camera. I completely understand where people were coming from and why they said no. This goes to show the challenging elements of being black and queer. I do want to give a huge shout out to the 10 people who were willing to participate. This video is gonna conclude the Black History Month series. All right, here it goes.
So the quote that I live my life by is that I would rather die on my feet than live on my knees, and that's by Frederick Douglass. And the reasoning behind that is because I can't conform to another person's idea of what I should be. That is my journey and my journey alone. And so if that meant that my life had to be taken in order for me to live freely, I am okay with that.
Being black through my eyes is to be a part of a community that doesn't fully accept you.
There's no way that a black queer woman or a black queer man is going to have the same experiences as a white queer man or white queer woman.
People don't always understand being black and gay.
The intersectionality of the two, it can make things a little bit more complicated.
I have three identities against me that the world doesn't necessarily respect or accept. I feel like I can't be who I was born to be because the world doesn't accept it, you know?
Being QPOC is literally a journey of alienation and isolation, as, you know, you're not receiving love and acceptance from the outside world, nor are you receiving love and acceptance from your own community.
I went through a lot of my life very timid about who I was, and I think I covered that with a lot of different things in order to exist.
It's funny that when people meet me for the first time, they automatically know that I'm a woman and that I'm black, but they never actually suspect that I could be lesbian or bisexual.
My skin comes first. That's what you see when you look at me immediately, is that I'm a black man.
It's having to deal with being looked at and judged based off of your skin color, and then on top of that, being judged based off of the way that you carry yourself.
It's something called heteronormativity, where everything is straight around you. Conversations are straight. Black love is straight. Black Lives Matter is straight.
The Black Lives Matter movement completely, in my opinion, leaves out other intersectionalities of women, but it really leaves out intersectionalities of people who are heterosexual.
Adds on to the patriarchy and the homophobia, because people choose to be blind to the fact that there are other identities in our community.
I'm fighting for you, but then who's fighting back for my rights? Who's fighting back for the queer lives? Who's fighting back for the trans lives?
I try not to let it affect me too much, but of course it's going to. Any person will tell you that's going to affect them in some way, somehow, in some place.
When I started college, I was really, really focused on trying to identify with being African American. Sophomore year, I decided to come out as queer, and it really shifted a lot. There was no way that I could be black and queer at the same time.
It was really hard to bring those intersecting identities together. Depending on what environment I'm in, I'm gonna have one identity more present than the other.
You're always put in a situation of choosing which group to support.
As I got to college and got more educated, I kind of started to learn more about what it means to be who you are and what your sexuality looks like, and how that may not coincide with what society may say.
It's something you always see, like your community doesn't like you. And it's sad in a sense, because all you hear in the media is faggots this and gay that, and it's sad to grow up with it in the music we go in, you grow up with it in the news, how it's so wrong for you, a black man, to love or have feelings for another man.
There's not a lot of images for queer people of color.
Noticing that there's such a lack of representation in general, for people like me.
The people that I did see were white males, and I did not identify as a white male, didn't identify as a white gay male. So what does a trans masculine lesbian of color do when they really don't identify within a binary, but they are female bodied and have to interact with the world as such? What does that look like for me?
Makes me feel sometimes like I don't have the same opportunities as other people, and like I can't do certain things or be in certain places because the world doesn't respect what I'm doing with my life.
Getting denied jobs just sometimes off bat. Doesn't matter how nice you are or how good you talk or how nice you dress, sometimes you're just not hired because you're black and you're dressed like a man.
I guess the hardest thing is being a Christian. A lot of people would consider it as hypocritical or whatnot, but that's always been a struggle in my life, and just going to church.
I also identify as Christian, and so you can kind of be like, wow, that's two different, or that's a contradiction for sure. But for me, it's my truth. And so for me, you know, I'm learning how to, you know, find out what works for me as a person, being someone who identifies with the K-pop community and being someone who also identifies as a Christian.
I used to be a youth pastor, and that all in itself was struggling with your own sexuality, and you love God. I love God, still do.
A lot of the values, especially in my family, that are associated with being black are about Christianity and religion and how our people got through things like slavery and the civil rights movement by their faith. So there was a lot of pushback in that space about talking about being queer.
Church is such a big part of the black community. It's hard for me to really just feel comfortable in those spaces because of the fact that I am gay.
Being gay, walking around in the church, you know people's eyes are going to be on you all the time. And how are you supposed to feel comfortable knowing that the world's looking at you? And you don't know what they're thinking. Like, do they accept me being who I am, or do they think I should not be who I am? Why do I feel comfortable doing this in this environment, you know?
It becomes extremely difficult to find acceptance in yourself and to love yourself and to even celebrate your queerness and your blackness coming into intersections with each other.
Me being black and being a male and being queer is definitely an experience. Specifically with the male part, I feel like, you know, society socializes males, especially black males, to have this hard persona, and anything outside of that is seen as being different and seen as negative.
I have to worry about whether I'm gonna have to get into a fight on a daily basis, because growing up as a man, a black man, you're growing with so much animosity towards each other.
I haven't told my dad is extremely homophobic. The hypermasculinity in the black community is real. He says very problematic things, and it's somebody who I really wouldn't feel comfortable coming out to.
A lot of times black men will tell me that I just need to have sex with them to be straight again, or that I'm too pretty to be gay, or that they think less of me because I like women.
It's definitely hard to kind of talk about my sexuality with a group of heterosexual men because of the stigmas that come with that. You know, sometimes I find it hard being able to express how I might feel or say things just because I don't personally want to make someone feel uncomfortable.
Really interesting coming out to my mom, who also identifies as black, because she kind of just said I was in denial, just completely just dismissed what I had told her, and then I was just experimenting, and eventually I'll be straight again. I'm just like, probably not.
I'm blessed with a family that still loves me. Of course, they don't fully accept me, but they do love the core me. But not everybody's blessed with that. A lot of times you get shunned.
A lot of black or people of color get shunned. And when they get welcomed in the queer community, it's finally like, hey, I'm finally welcomed. And so they kind of just dismiss their racial identity, which I feel like is problematic.
There's a lot of gay spaces that are predominantly white. A lot of times I don't feel comfortable in those predominantly white spaces. Your space that you reside in on a regular basis is so important to your survival, because it's hard to live stifled. So it's so necessary to surround yourself with people that allow you to express yourself and be the real you, the whole you.
Growing up, I didn't see people who look like me, and therefore For a very long time, I was very isolated and I segregated myself.
Like, visibility is so important because we just have to be there more. Otherwise, we're just going to be erased from history, which would really suck because there's a lot of us and there's a lot that we can do.
I didn't feel as though I fit into any norm by the way that I identified. I wasn't feminine enough to hang out with the women, and I wasn't masculine enough to hang out with the men. So because of that, I really didn't know where my place was. I didn't want to be butch in the sense of I didn't want to be mistaken as a man, because I think manhood and womanhood is about character.
So I might have some feminine tendencies, I might also have some male tendencies, but it's who I am and it's what makes me a queer person of color and what makes me a black man at the end of the day.
I remember I had a very serious relationship with a guy who was cisgendered as well. I just brought him to the family barbecue and they're like, oh, this is Muhammad's friend. When in reality, this was my boyfriend, and they couldn't understand that. When I brought a girl around, it was, oh, this is Muhammad's girlfriend, even if she was my friend.
I have only dated one person, black person of color in my lifetime, probably, up to now. Everybody's pretty much been white, which has always been really interesting. They never really understood.
I've only been in interracial relationships, and all with white women. And I think that there's going to be different expectations and different experiences that the other person isn't going to understand.
I appreciate that I have the perspective on the world that I do.
It's hard, but I love it. I love all the aspects of my identity.
The journey of being black and queer is challenging, and it's just about learning how to love yourself regardless of the outside world and the inner community literally not being there for you.
When I was able to be myself, when I was able to be okay with the uncomfortability of being me, I have been able to flourish.
I am my own type of woman.
I'm really proud to be a queer person of color and to finally feel power in accepting both of those identities.
Being black and queer, I wouldn't change anything about it.
I've always accepted who I was and never had a problem with showing that. I've always been proud of who I was.
So when I think about QPOC folks and what it means to be black, it is finding the intersectionality that I am both things equally, and I cannot separate my blackness from my queerness. It is one and the same, and it makes me who I am.
All right, y'all, thank you for watching. I want to again thank everyone who has participated in all of the Black History Month series that I was doing. I also wanted to give a huge shout out to the person who found all of the music. So I don't know if you could tell or not, but the music in the background of each video was really meaningful for that specific video. If you couldn't tell, you should go back and listen. So shout out to you, Aaliyah Jones. Stay tuned for more videos coming soon. If you haven't watched all of these videos, catch up on them. All right, Yiggity, peace up, A-Town down. Damn, I love your crooked smile. Face ain't shade, you're wild and free, but you never go out of style. You look too good to be mad. You got way too much class.